Sleep apnea syndrome is a condition which is an aftermath of excessive snoring over a prolonged period of time. One third of our population would be snoring. Snoring is considered to be an innocuous condition where people are really not bothered except for disturbing the partner, or the partner probably just gets up and goes to the other room to sleep, which is almost happening in our setup now, very, very frequently, if you really go into details of history of the patient who's been snoring for some time. But what we need to understand is the snoring is a sound which is produced by soft tissues of the throat because air passes through these passages which are narrowed down because of either excessive fat or decrease in muscle tone or other conditions which cause more fat to be deposited in these soft tissues. And these areas of narrowing will then produce vibration causing snoring to be heard by the partner or somebody else who's close to the patient who's sleeping. As we sleep, the muscles are known to relax. That is the main reason why we need to sleep, isn't it? We are basically relaxing, we are throwing away all the toxins which have been covered up during the day and rejuvenating ourselves for the next day's hard work. Now these muscles, when they relax and there's an obstruction occurring at the same time, the obstruction becomes so much that the airway just completely collapses. Once this area collapses, there is a period of no breathing, in spite of the fact that the person who's sleeping is trying to make an effort to breathe in very hard, but there is no air going in. And there is a period of no breathing called apnea, which results in decreased oxygenation and increased carbon dioxide during that time. Now, this reduction in oxygen levels has serious implications on our body. The sleep at that point in time, which has gone into a deep sleep because the patient is relaxed, subconsciously wakes the patient up into superficial planes of sleep. This sleep fragmentation occurring so many times in the night in these people who have been obstructing and collapsing of airway will lead to excessive daytime sleepiness in these situations. And you find these people to be very sleepy during the day. They might just sleep off while driving a car, they might sleep off while actually doing heavy machinery, working on the heavy machinery, or they might just sleep off in a meeting which is going on, and it sometimes gets to be quite embarrassing, so to say.